this program design resource is unlike any other resource on program design you've seen before, because this one is actually 100% relevant to what the everyday personal trainers like you and I are seeing with everyday clients. And we'll get into that a little bit as we see some of the earlier slides that we're going to get into about our principles and philosophies. So it's important, before we talk about programming, we talk about who are we programming for, more specifically, who are we not. Now, talking a little bit about in-season and off-season and some of these periodization concepts and methodologies that we always hear about when it comes to program design, and I kind of joked and I said the difference between this course, this resource, and a lot of other programming courses is this one's actually going to be relevant to what most of us trainers are seeing with most of our clients. Well, it really comes down to this stuff here. The everyday client doesn't have an in-season or off-season. They're not peaking for anything. And sometimes if you're a trainer like myself, I've had clients for 10, man, I've had actually one client for 20 years, slightly over 20 years now. So in a lot of trainers, if you're like me, you have a very high retention rate. So it's not about looking at, oh, what are we going to do for this 12-week program or this 8-week program? That's great. But what are we going to do over this long term? And I mean for several years, right? So many clients stay with you for 5, 10 years, hopefully, if you're good at your job, right? But the everyday client is constantly missing sessions and moving things around and coming in to you on the session and say, hey, can we not do legs today because my knee's a little sore, because my old college roommate came into town this weekend and we decided to go play tennis, or I was gardening all weekend. So it's a lot more of a fluid process, and it's a much harder to stack days, meaning I'm building off of what I did here to do this next phase. So obviously we want to have that plan in place, but we need to have a programming framework and model that is fluid and adaptable enough that it's not dependent on the preceding workout, because as we said, they're constantly missing sessions. Interestingly enough, when you look at all these bullet points I've laid out here, most periodization, i.e. program design info, is designed around the completely opposite parameters of that, which is why a lot of personal trainers who are very intelligent and constantly getting educated are still very confused with programming. It's not that you don't understand it or that you don't know how to apply it. It's that the information that's being provided doesn't really apply to the settings that most of us work in. We can learn some elements from it, absolutely, some of the principles there. But what's actually happening on the gym floor is what we have now brought into this course to give you the solutions to do better on the gym floor, versus trying to take what's in those books and try to put them to the gym floor. So we go the opposite here. We take what's actually happening on the gym floor, bring it here to the conversation, to the resource, and then come back with a more refined and improved, better way with solutions to the problems that we deal with actually on the gym floor.